Hello, everybody, and welcome to a special late edition of Man Shit Monday. Man Shit Monday on Tuesday. So, Man Shit Tuesday. Sorry, I was really busy this weekend and I just couldn't get the edit done in time, so. So whether it's Monday or Tuesday or whatever day you're going to be watching this, today, after I've teased this for several weeks, maybe even longer, it's finally done, and we're going to take a look at the new cigar room. So the cigar room is finally done, and I'm super happy. It's been over a month working on this room. I did all the work in here myself. A, I just like to do it, and B, it saves a lot of money when you do the work yourself. So it did take me a little over a month to get it complete, but it is finally done, and I am super excited. I use it all the time. So when I came up with the idea to make the cigar room in the house, I had 99 problems, and 98 and a half of them were my wife. If your spouse, significant other, I do have some ladies that watch this channel, so maybe you want to build a cigar room and it's your husband that'll have the problem with the smoke. Regardless of the fact, you don't want your whole house smelling like cigars. I have children that live in my house, so I don't want them exposed to smoke of any secondhand smoke of any nature. So you really, when you're building a cigar room, it's a little different than remodeling just any old room. There's some extra considerations that go into constructing a room like this. Firstly, let's talk about that part of it. This is a spare bedroom in my house. It's across the hall from my office. The only thing that's up here is my office, a bathroom, and this room, which right off the bat makes it a good candidate because there's no other rooms close by up here and it's upstairs and smoke rises. So that's always a plus. First thing, ripped all the carpet up, put down hardwood floors to keep there from being too many soft surfaces. Soft surfaces absorb smoke and the room will stink. I also took down the curtains that used to be in this room and put in some wood blinds instead. Again, getting rid of as many soft surfaces as possible that could absorb smoke. You also don't want smoke escaping the room, so you're gonna have to keep your door closed all the time. With that, I didn't want to feel trapped and claustrophobic in this room, so I took the normal panel door down and I put in a French glass door. That allows some light to get into the room. It allows it to seem a little less claustrophobic when the door is closed, and I also put weather stripping all the way around it like you would an exterior door, which helps any smoke from escaping the room. Now ventilation, and I may do a full video on this if you guys want to put comments below on the how I did the ventilation in this room to keep the smoke down. I did add two exhaust vents to this room, which run off of an inline fan, and it exhausts all the air and smoke out of this room directly out the soffits of the house, so to get all that smoke out. There's also a ceiling fan in here, which helps keep the air moving around. And last but definitely not least, the kind folks at Rabbit Air sent me a Rabbit Air air purifier. Full review coming on that, so keep a lookout on the channel for that if you're interested. The Rabbit air purifier is great. It's like a five or seven stage filter. It's got multiple filters in it to clean the air, and then a charcoal filter which removes odors from the air. So that thing has really been beast. Between the ventilation, that making the room fairly airtight, the fan, and the Rabbit Air, you stay pretty good to go with keeping your air quality good in here. In a cigar room, ventilation is key. A, you don't want it getting out into your house, stinking up your whole house, and B, you want it to be a pleasant experience when you're in the room. If you don't vent the room well and the smoke builds up in here, your eyes are gonna sting, it's gonna be hard to breathe, and that's not gonna make for an enjoyable cigar smoking experience. So moving on from that and going more into just the look of the room. This room already had crown molding in it, but I added molding to the walls to give it that kind of old world loungy kind of feel. And then I painted all the walls and the ceiling a dark gray. I think the darker colors really kind of lend to that lounge feel. Smoke from cigars or any kind of smoke has a tendency to make white surfaces look yellow. Most ceilings are white. I have a feeling if I didn't do that in probably like a year, that ceiling would have been yellow and nasty. So I just went ahead and painted it dark gray to match all the walls. I think overall it's going to hold up better. And then I put four can lights, recessed lights, in this room. I really like recessed lighting. It kind of adds a nice even light. I put smart bulbs in all of them so I can change it from like a real orange kind of color to more of a daylight color, get it nice and dim with kind of a warm light. It's all going for that kind of lounge, that cigar room kind of feel. And I think it looks pretty loungy in here. I like it. I'm happy with it. Now, moving around behind me, I put in a custom bar. This room luckily had kind of a recessed area, and as soon as I saw that, I'm like, boom, bar is going there. That'll be dope. So the top on the bar I built in the exact same method that I used to make the desktops I've done a video on in the past, and made the bar top out of solid wood. Then I made a shelving unit to go below it that allowed me to build in my humidor and a mini fridge. What bar would be complete without the mini fridge? Gives me a good place to keep some nice ice cold beers, some ice cubes for my whiskey if I choose to put ice in a whiskey. Everybody, when I did the whiskey video, some people get really bent out of shape about putting ice in the whiskey, so just calm down. It's okay to put ice in whiskey sometimes, but gives me a good place to store my ice, a couple Cokes, some beers and stuff like that, so we don't have to go downstairs when we need that stuff. The humidor is the New Air, I think it's the 350 or 450 cc. It's the bigger version of the New Air humidor. I've got a review on that also if you want to check it out. Great humidor, I love that thing. And I really like the built-in look. I think it gives it kind of a more custom polished look, so I really, really like that. Now, you may notice neither the humidor nor the mini fridge I have up here are intended to be built in. Actually, I think the manual strictly says do not build them in. But generally that's because if they're not made to be built in, they don't have the correct ventilation and stuff, and they can overheat. What I did to circumvent that, and before I tell you this, if you choose to do this yourself, do not get mad at me if something goes wrong. This is just what I chose to do. Follow your manual if you want to be safe. Let's just get that clear. But what I did is the bar area is about 25, 26 inches deep. Both the humidor and the mini fridge are only about 19. So that gives me a good 5-6 inches behind either unit of airspace. Also, the shelving unit in the middle here is only about 15 inches deep, and it has a completely mesh back. You can get this like brass looking mesh stuff from Home Depot, which allows me to have a nice big area behind both the units with good ventilation so the air can get back there and keep everything nice and cool. Been back there for quite a while now. Neither unit gets warm. Everything seems to be good to go. I think it's working great, but do it at your own risk. Instructions say don't build them in. So I really think the built-in look looks really dope. I really like it, and I'm happy I did it. Now, above that, I built a custom pipe shelf. I really like these pipe shelves. I have some in my office. I like them because I really like the look of them. I like the whole industrial kind of feel they've got, and they're fairly inexpensive to make. They're pretty easy to do, and you can custom make them to any size and shape you really need. Also, because they are made of pipe and they're hollow, makes very convenient place to run wiring for lighting. In my case, if you'll notice, I have some Edison bulbs on mine to kind of add some accent lighting. Really great, easy just to run that wire straight down those pipes, gives you a good clean place to hide it, and it looks like a built-in light that was kind of custom made. So I really like that, looks really dope. Also, you'll notice there are some LEDs behind these shelves for backlighting. Thought they would look really cool, especially behind the whiskey bottles. And again, because those pipe shelves are hollow, gives you a great place to hide the wire. On the shelves, you will notice my whiskey collection. This isn't all the whiskey I have. I have some more downstairs, but I moved about half to three quarters of it up here. Really think it kind of adds to the look of the room. And obviously we're smoking cigars and drinking whiskey in here. It's good to have some on hand. Above that, I just put some kind of knickknacks, some things that are personal to me. There's a bottle of Woodford Reserve from a Kentucky Derby many years ago that a family member had given me that I keep up there. And in front of it is actually pretty cool. That's a horseshoe from a horse from Churchill Downs. And it actually has dirt in the horseshoe from Churchill Downs, where they do the Kentucky Derby. It's one of my favorite little accessories up here. Really dope. So moving around to the main seating area, which is kind of an important part of a cigar lounge, you gotta have somewhere to sit, some nice comfy chairs. But I had to be careful when I was picking out furniture for this room, because this isn't a big room. This room's only about 12 by 12 and a half or 12 by 13. So I couldn't get huge, huge overstuffed things. What we got in here is we have four leather chairs. Two of them are brown tufted leather chairs. Two of them are black leather swivel chairs. The reason I put swivel chairs on one side is because along the back wall here, I mounted a 40-inch flat screen TV so I could watch TV in here. I could catch up on YouTube stuff, or if my friends are over and they wanted to watch some sports or whatnot, I could watch movies in here. The two black chairs, your back is to the TV, so that would have been pretty annoying. I bought the swivel chairs so that way when people are sitting in those chairs, if they want to watch the TV, they can just swivel the chair right around, and they can see the TV just fine. In the middle of the seating area, I wanted something that was comfortable that people could put their feet on, but also gave somewhere that people could set some drinks down or something like that. So what I did is I put a big leather ottoman with a tray in the middle, which allows people to still put their feet up, but you can set your drink down on the tray and stuff. Kind of served dual purpose. It's really nice when you're smoking a cigar to sit back in a comfy leather chair, kick the old feet up, and just kind of puff on that thing and really relax and enjoy it. Below the ottoman, I put a cowhide rug. You gotta have some kind of rug of some nature. You can't have just hardwood floors. It doesn't feel good on the feet, and you just need something to soften things up a little bit. It's kind of crazy. It's kind of a brindle looking thing, which I've never seen a brindle cow before, but it almost kind of looks like tiger stripes. Pretty neat rug, really. Gotta just hope nobody from PETA comes over and throws red paint on my rug. I mean, it's from a cow. It's not like a wild animal. It's a byproduct of the meat industry, so that makes it a little better, right? Nobody come and throw paint on my rug, please. Now, in between the chairs, obviously in a cigar room, you're gonna need a place for ashtrays. You're gonna need a place to set your cigar down, have your cigar lighter. So I have some small end tables in between the chairs. Again, I had to watch size. This isn't a big room, so they're just big enough that you got a good place to put your ashtray down, your cigar lighter, maybe set your drink, keep everything at arm's reach. So you'll notice on the table is this Zycar lighter. I mention it because several people have asked me from other videos what lighter this is. This is a Zycar Verano flat flame lighter. I love this thing. You can't really see it when it's light. It's hard to see the flame, but it's a flat flame. It's really dope. This is my go-to. I keep it up here all the time. And because this is a cigar room, I will mention these cigar ashtrays that are up here. Both of these I picked up on Amazon for really inexpensive. I have some really huge cigar ashtrays that I like that I keep outside for like the big tables. But since these are small side tables, these are smaller ashtrays. The one on the one table is like brass with a leather wrap. Really like it. Very inexpensive on Amazon. And on the other one, it's an all porcelain ashtray. It's black with gold accents. It's a three cigar ashtray. It's really good. It's like under $20 for that ashtray, I think, so you can't beat it. And again, both of those, I got them because specifically they're a little bit smaller and they fit well on the table so that you still have room for drinks and stuff. And moving around to some of the stuff on the walls, I got a few skulls because, well, skulls are dope. I mean, what says man shit more than skulls on the wall? I mean, they're just good. Got a big old silver and gold steer skull above the TV. Again, nothing really behind it other than the fact I thought it looked really good and it kind of went with the room. I think it's a requirement, actually. Like when you're checking out a list of man cave stuff, it's like, do you have skulls? Yes, check. You know, it's one of those things. On the other wall, I have two pictures that you might have seen in your life. Both of them are pretty popular pictures. One is of Jack Nicholson smoking a cigar, which I thought was perfectly fitting for a cigar room. It's just a really iconic, I think it's a really cool picture. I actually edited it a little bit in Lightroom and did my own kind of touch on it and got it printed up. But really, really love that picture. Think it fits good. And the other one, if you don't know who this other picture is of, then you're not a cigar smoker. And for God's sake, there's a size of cigar named after him, the Churchill. That is Winston Churchill, the man. Got a stogie hanging out of his mouth, a Tommy gun. I mean, dude, you can't get more boss than that picture of that guy right there. I love that picture. So anyway, those are the two pictures I put up. Thought they kind of match the room and I like looking at them. They make me happy when I'm smoking my cigars. So that's about it. There's some other little small odds and ends. I have a custom-made knife that a friend of the family made me that I keep up here and just some other things. The room's not completely done. I feel like this room's gonna kind of evolve as time goes. I'll get some new cool stuff and maybe take some of the other stuff down and add different stuff and move it around. But it's basically what it is for now. And I have to say, I love it. I've been using it a ton. It's great. I'm gonna start shooting all the Man Shit Monday videos in here. Start doing some cigar reviews and stuff in here, maybe some knife reviews. It should be a lot of fun. I'll tell you one thing, if you don't want to spend a lot more money on cigars, do not put a cigar room in your house, because since I've had this room, I'm like a kid with a new toy. I use it all the time. I've been smoking way more than I used to because this room is up here. So if you don't want to up your cigar budget for the month, don't put a cigar room in your house. It's a no-go. So that's it. That wraps another one up. As always, I will link as much of this stuff as I can down below. So if you guys are interested in anything or need some information, you know where to find it. I did want to say quick thank you to my folks at Beard Brand for sending me out this awesome shirt. You know you're representing, by the way, when you got to move your beard to the side to even see the logo of your shirt. Representing that bearded life. Come on. If you've never had Temple Smoke or Old Money Beard Oil, you're missing out. That stuff smells phenomenal. Those are definitely two of my top five scents of all beard oils I've ever tried. I really like Beard Brand, though. It's a good company. They've got a lot of great information on YouTube, and I like to support those guys. So if you guys haven't checked them out, I'll link their website and YouTube page down below. So check them out. I hope you guys liked the new Cigar Room and enjoyed hanging out with me for a little while today. If you did, feel free to smash that like button. That always helps us out. If you're not a subscriber, please consider doing so. We'd love to have you on board. I hope everyone is having a fantastic week, and we will see you in the next video.